let us all that we can to build a better future.
Any case, we know that Apple is now going to be delaying its return to the offices as the current variant continues to spread. These major companies are trying to make some decisions. They were going to have everybody come back in September. Now they're looking at October at the earliest. What I guess I want to point out about this, I know that a lot of people are not necessarily working for the big tech companies, but I want to point out that, again, this is going to have impact on schools. When kids are schools, child care, we're looking at a situation where a lot of women have had to leave the workforce. And I think that this is going to continue to be a massive cultural sea change. This is beyond, I think, employment right now. We're looking at some really serious cultural sea changes, particularly when you've got the major tech companies that are doing this, and a whole lot of we don't know what's going on in terms of how this situation is being managed here in the U.S. and around the world. And I did want to bring that up because I think it's significant. And it's more than just corporate policies at this point. We're looking at perhaps some permanent or reasonably permanent changes in our expectations. I was born in 1969. And yes, there were women were entering the workforce at that point, but there was still strong sexual division of labor. We saw this change, and I don't know that it was entirely always for the good, only because there being an emphasis on economic empowerment for all people, we just basically saw people being turned into worker bees for major corporations. If people are starting to pull back from that so that they can take care of their kids largely out of necessity, that may not be such a bad thing, but we still have the problem of the people who are going to be left behind, who are being penalized economically because they can't afford to live on one income. But we're also going to be looking at what is going to happen with the role of women in our society if women are pulling out of these high-powered, high-paying careers because they've had this massive disruption in their career.
And it's crazy because there's a whole... And especially if you're talking about a high-end career, your top tier, like pulling out for a year or two, you're not on track anymore. Yeah. So this has got to be, like, a lot of people talk about, we need each of these various demographic groups to put in more. This is like a thing that, like, every single person that pulled out for a year or two, they were no longer on track. So this is just devastating to a lot of the long term. I mean, like, I don't know the numbers. I'm just going to make up some, but like, we just lost 1,000 potential CEOs in 30 years.
So, knowing how COVID-19 is going to still play a role, everyone just look, wash your hands, wear a mask, be safe. We're still going to be dealing with this fight for some time, and its impact on our society will be felt for many more years to come. So, look, just take care of yourselves. That's the only advice I can give.